Did you know that Amazon is the world's largest search engine, just behind Google and YouTube? Did you know that Amazon's revenue was at $386 billion last year alone? Did you know that Amazon also has a fund that goes towards Kindle sales and rewards authors whose books people borrow and read for free? Last month, the fund was set at $39.7 million. And did you know how easy it is to make $1,000 per month on Amazon? So whether you're interested in quitting your job and working full-time online or having an additional income stream, in this video, you will learn how to easily make $1,000 per month or more with Amazon Kindle self-publishing. It's so easy to implement that literally anyone can do it in just 30 minutes flat. Let's get into the method. All right, so here are my stats for Amazon Kindle. As you can see, these are real numbers from the Amazon's website, and you can see that I actually do sell books on there. These are not made up numbers or anything. And if we go into my dashboard, you can see that I have a bunch of books. Now, I'm not showing what kind of books I'm selling for obvious reasons, but you can see that I do have books there that are being sold. Now that you've seen everything, you've seen that I'm actually playing in the game as well, I want to tell you how exactly you can do it and how you can start making some extra money. So if you go on Amazon, Amazon is selling a ton of stuff, right? So Amazon is the world's third largest search engine. A lot of people don't realize it. They think about Google, YouTube, and those are big too, but Amazon is actually right behind YouTube for the number three spot, okay? So when people type something like how to make money online, how to make money in stocks, it's kind of like going to Google, right? I can go to Google and type how to make money in stocks, and Google is going to show me web pages, or I can go to YouTube and it's going to show me YouTube videos, or I can go to Amazon here and I can type it as well and I can see books, right? I want to buy a book. I don't want to just browse different websites, and right away I have books. Now, what you guys need to understand is that some books are obviously created by, you know, big time, big name authors. Some books are written by just regular people like me and you. And so everybody has a chance on Amazon, right? It's an even playing field. Now, before we get into the subject of actually going out and creating the book, how to do it properly, let's talk about the niche. What is your book gonna be about? And then later on, I'm gonna explain to you that you can even publish a book that you are not gonna write yourself, that you never written yourself. So I'm gonna show you exactly how you can do that. But the next important thing is the niche, okay? So we have good niches for Amazon Kindle. I googled that. Here's an article, right? You wanna do a research on the niche, okay? Do not go into a niche that you have no interest in, right? So five best money-making Kindle niches 2020 and beyond, right? So you can take a look. Business and investing, computer and technology, health, fitness and dieting, self-help, parenting and relationship. So if you've been, you know, around affiliate marketing for a while now, you kind of already should recognize these niches, and these niches, they work anywhere. And that is because if a person wants to buy a product, there's going to be certain areas that where there's demand. If they want to, you know, do Google searches or find videos, there's going to be certain areas where there's demand. Same thing with books. There's going to be certain areas where there's going to be a lot of demand, right? Business investing, tech, health, self-help, and parents. I would even say it's number one, number three, number four, and these two and five are kind of extra, right? Because what we have is health, wealth, and relationships, right? These main three areas where there's always going to be demand, right? So my advice is you want to research the kind of niche. My niche is actually in the self-help category, okay? I decided to go down that niche because I know that make money online is very oversaturated. Business investing is very oversaturated. Health and dieting is oversaturated. But self-help is a wide open niche. You can talk about anything. You can talk about self-improvement. You can talk about public speaking. You can talk about, you know, becoming more confident. There's a lot of things that you can talk about. And my personal opinion, this is a very, very underrated niche, this self-help, okay? So this is a really, really good niche. And now that you understand what kind of area you want to go into, you want to do a little bit more research. So for instance, let's say we want to do self-help categories. I want to do self-help categories. I want to figure out what kind of self-help I can talk about. So here we go, types of self-help. You want to kind of dig deeper, right? So because, you know, self-help is a very broad category. You want to go deeper, right? You want to go deeper. So types of self-help. Here we have types of self-help. Find recovery from addiction or alcohol, break free from anger, find relief, improve relationships, take advantage of self-help. So there's, you know, a bunch of categories. And honestly, guys, this is very, very easy. Self-help is anything to do with self-improvement. So whether it's dating, marriage counseling, whether it's, you know, becoming more confident. It has to do with confidence. It's a very, very psychological area, right? Provided that this is what you want to talk about. You can kind of research more about it, categories of self-help or how to book. Let's take a look. Self-help or how to book, right? There's a lot of categories. Publishers in the industry classify self-help or how to books into these five categories. They are a step-by-step type book, a progression type book, a recovery, an exercise, a component-based book. And honestly, this is very helpful. You can have a step-by-step. I had no idea that, you know, this kind of information was out there. I wish I read these articles before I actually went out and wrote my books, right? Because I had no idea this stuff existed. I just wrote a book on, you know, just a random topic. I didn't really do that. I didn't really prepare as I'm showing you guys now. And if we go to Wikipedia, this is another area, right? The market, seeker, self-help marketplace. There you have the subgenre of self-help book series also exists, such as For Dummies, The Complete Idiot's Guide, etc., etc. You can research more. And my opinion is you want to spend a lot of time researching. This is very, very important, right? So we're Googling a lot of stuff. And we're trying to understand. Maybe you want to create a step-by-step book. Take a look at this one. Self-help definition examples, right? Review this list of popular examples to help you get a better understanding of the self-help nonfiction niche. A New Earth Awakening, right? Eat, Pray, Love, Emotional Intelligence. This is another really, really good way to figure out what kind of book you want to write. What kind of, you know, because it's not even about the kind of book, right? It begins before that, right? You need the right title. You need to connect with the audience. If you have an amazing book, but the wrong title, it's going to be hard to sell it because nobody's going to find it. So, Who Moved My Cheese, Think and Grow, Women. So, maybe some of you have even read some of these books here simply because they're so popular. And if you have any slight interest in self-help, you have probably have read some of these books or, you know, many of these books as well, right? So now that you understand how to do basic research, you want to go on Amazon and you want to start doing research here. So let's say I want to do how to improve, how to gain self-confidence. I'm going to type that. And Amazon pre-fill. So we have unstoppable self-confidence, killing weakness. And what you want to see is when you type a title, you want to see what kind of results pop in, right? Because what you don't want to see is you don't want to see a very competitive landscape, okay? It's kind of like with Google. When you type a query, you don't want to see links that have a lot of backlinks, right? Because it's going to take a lot of time. Here, you don't want to see books with a lot of reviews. So if you see books, these are ads. You can ignore this. These are ads sponsored. You see it says sponsor right here? You see how it says sponsored right here? And you can ignore this sponsor. Now, we have this other one, right? So if you go in here, we have 10 simple solutions for building self-esteem, gain self-doubt, gain confidence, and create a positive image, right? So here you go. Here you go as an example of a book. This is number one, and it's only 87 reviews. Let's scroll down. No reviews. No reviews. 20 reviews, right? So we can do more research, right? We can actually click on the book and see when it was published, right? This was published in 2007, and it has only 87 ratings, which is not a lot at all. Let's go back. Let's check the second result, right? So how about this one? Was this? No, that one I just checked. Let's go back. How about this one right here? This is sponsored. We're going to skip this one, and we're going to go to this one. And yeah, it actually says there. It says if you scroll down a little bit, you're going to see 2014 is when it was published. So this is a book from all the way, you know, that's 6-7 years ago, even more. That's still ranking, right? With only 20 reviews, right? Alpha Mindset, 2021, just published 20 reviews. And it's, you know, on the first page, somewhere in the middle of the page. So this sounds like a good category. Whereas if you type something like How to make money in stocks. Let me show you a competitive category. First of all, you have these bestsellers. These are sponsored, right? These are sponsored, but this is not sponsored. It was published in 2009. It has almost 3,000 reviews and it has a bestseller. It's going to be very hard to compete with it, right? So I would not recommend going into this niche. You have similar books. Look at this one, 3,000 reviews. We have this book sponsored. 386 reviews, 427 reviews, right? Let's see, 179 reviews, 4 reviews, 94 reviews. So this, as you can see, this is a lot more competitive niche. It's a more competitive niche. It's going to be a lot, it's going to be harder to gain traction, right? And you can type anything, right? How to become rich, you know? It's going to be also probably a very competitive niche. Right, let's take a look. These are sponsored, and now we have sponsored, more sponsored, and these are audiobooks, some paper books. Look at this. The list is different, right? This is a different type of list. And look at this one. 8,874 reviews, 6,000 reviews, right? What else we have? 10,000, almost 11,000 reviews, 5,000 reviews. Everybody wants to be rich. And that's why, you know, these books, 830 reviews, right? 56,000 reviews. This is a classic. Think and Grow Rich by Napoleon Hill. This is a classic. 56,000 reviews, 282 reviews, 439, 21,000 reviews. This is also a classic. And so as you can see, this specific niche is more competitive. It's very, very, very important for you guys to spend time researching and spend time understanding exactly what's happening. You got to understand what's happening in your niche. A lot of people don't spend the time. And unless you're going to go into a very obscure niche, it's very, very important to spend time to understand exactly what's happening, and that way you're gonna be more successful. So now that you understand what kind of title you wanna do, maybe you're getting ideas for the colors of your cover that you can go on Fiverr and create for like $5 to $10. We're not gonna discuss that in this video. That's a very, very simple thing. Maybe I'll make another video later on. The next thing is you wanna think about how to actually create this book. Now you have a lot of options, right? You have three options when you're talking about creating the book. Number one is you can write it yourself. So you can sit down, you can write it yourself. I wrote my books myself. Number two, you can hire somebody else to write it for you. You can go on a place like Upwork. You can find people to write it for you. You can even go on Fiverr, but I probably recommend Upwork. They have a higher quality over there for that kind of work. You can have somebody write it for you. That's called a ghostwriter. It's a person, it's actually a profession. There are people that do it all their lives. They build a career of writing other people's book. And the third option is you can actually buy this content and use it in your product, whatever you're selling. So a blog article, video, book, etc. And that is called PLR, private label rights. So you can just Google PLR products. And you're gonna see a lot of products. There's plrproducts.com, database, buy quality PLR. You have a lot of sites. I actually used the site a while ago for a couple of projects. I never had any problems. But let's say we go to the first result, right? We're gonna take a look at what you have here. And you can buy all kinds of content. Thousands of resell rights, ebook, articles, software, videos, and more. And what's nice about it is that you're buying content that you can use. It's not like you're stealing somebody. That's the whole purpose of this kind of product, is that you're buying it for resale, for ability to resell it, right? PLR stands for private label rights. Private as in you, label as in you can label yourself, and rights means you have the rights to do it. So I have the private rights, I have my own rights to label this content as my own product. That is kind of the beautiful thing. And you can scroll down, you have new products, you have all kinds. You can buy, you know, distraction-free ways. You can buy a book and you can repackage it and sell it on Amazon. You can edit it. You can hire somebody called a copy editor, which is a person that's gonna reword the book, change it around. So I would not recommend just buying something like this and selling it on Amazon. You wanna repurpose it, or you can do it yourself, or you can hire somebody, right? For building character, look at this, all of this, This one, these are all self-help books, right? This is, and yeah, this one, and not this one. So one, two, three. So this one, and this one, these are all self-help books. So you can take this content. So let's say we want this one, right? Let's see how many pages it is. Let's take a look. So I'm going to open it up right here. Let's see how many pages it is. It was added July 2021, so fairly recently. And so when you open this product, you can see exactly what's happening. You have license terms, can be sold, can be used for personal use, and you can kind of see what's happening. It cannot be given away for free, can be added. It cannot be added to free membership website, cannot convey and sell a private label rights, which is fine because everything else is perfect for us, right? Can be packaged with other products, can be sold, can be this, can be that. You can do a lot of things with it. And typically that's what you're getting when you buy this kind of book. You can resell it for many, many copies. And so it's really up to you what you want to do. Now, once you decided that you want to do it, you want to save it, you want to create it. You can create it in Microsoft Word, you can create it in Google Docs, you can create it in a PDF kind of app. Once you're done, you're going to go to kdp.amazon.com and you're gonna see this kind of dashboard here. You're going to see your existing books. So if you're brand new to it, you're not going to see any books here. And all you have to do is click on Kindle eBook. We're going to do this together. I'm going to show you how you can do it. You're going to say English book title. I'm going to say whatever the book is, right? We did our research, how to be confident step-by-step guide. Or something like this, how to be confident in 21 steps or in 21 days. Perfect. How to gain confidence, you can say, or how to be confident in 21 days. You don't need a subtitle, you don't need series, you don't need that. Then you have your author. This could be your real name. You can use a pen pal, you can use another name, it's up to you. You don't need contributors unless you want to do that. Here you have the description, right? So I'm going to just say, this is a description of my future book, okay? You're going to say, I own the copyright and hold the necessary publishing rights. You're going to have the keywords here. So the keywords are going to be how to become confident, how to gain confidence, becoming confident, okay? The other thing that you can do is you can go on Amazon and you can type it and seeing what kind of books pop up. Right, seeing the titles, evolving self, how to become free from anxiety, you can, how to become this, unstoppable, how to create and thus, you know, etc. You can use the terms, you can see the kind of results you're seeing to structure your keywords, right? Becoming confidence, categories, you can set categories, and categories, you can even see it in the book. So for instance, let's open this book right here, and let's scroll down, and we have categories. Here you have, this is the general category, right? You see this right here, work-life balance, inner child self-help, family health, and you can see how it's ranked, and this is a fairly good rank, right? Anything below 50,000 is a fairly good rank. They're making some money. They're not making a lot of money. Below 10,000 is you're starting to see some real money, but below 50,000 is good enough, right? It's good enough for what we're trying to do here. You're going to go, you're going to pick the categories here. So let's say I pick nonfiction, architecture, something like this. Say general, I pick these. I'm going to hit save. We're not going to set this. I'm ready to release my book now. I'm going to save and continue. And so here's the second step. Kindle eBook content, right? Enable DRM. You can set that to no. And here is where you upload the manuscript. And it says recommended formats for Kindle eBooks, doc, DOCX, which is Microsoft Word or Google Docs, EPUB and KPF. These two, you can set it up in Google Docs, right? You can have this kind of format. So as long as you have the book, you will be able to upload it fine. They used to support mobile, but now they do not. That's absolutely fine. Then you have your cover ebook. This is optional. There's a previewer, so you can actually preview the book when you upload it. You're going to see what it looks like. You're going to see how it actually appears. And then you can go on Fiverr and hire a gig, right? So if you go on Fiverr, so here you go, create ebook cover, and you can have for $5. You can have a really nice cover. Look at this, $10, a nice cover. If you want to spend $30, you're going to have something even better. But like I said, anywhere from $5 to $10, you're going to have a fairly good cover for your ebooks, all right? And so once you upload the cover, once you upload the ebook, you're going to go to the final stage, and this is where you're going to set the price. And I recommend setting the price similar to some of these other books. So this book is what, $7.99? I recommend setting it anywhere from $5.99 to $9.99, right? So like $7.99, $6.99, $8.99. These are all good prices. That's what I recommend. You can also include your book inside the Kindle Unlimited program, meaning like if they're a member of that Kindle Unlimited program, that book is going to be free for these people, and you're going to get money, you're going to get royalties from the fund, depending on how much of the book the people read. So if they read like a lot of pages, you're going to get more money. And that's really all there is to it. That is as simple as that. And now, not only are you creating content for Google, for YouTube, you're also creating content for Amazon. That is the way I do it. And that is the way I know a lot of people who are making online do it. They want to cover all of their bases. And so that is the method I wanted to share with you guys today. I really hope you've gotten value here. And if you want to see another really, really good method, check out the video that you see on your screen right now.